Well, hello everyone, Smithy here, and welcome back to another episode of Jurassic World, Jurassic Park, Minecraft. And we're back on Isla Nublar for this episode, but this is a different Isla Nublar for our previous one. You'll notice behind me, look how far back it goes, to the mountains. Yes, we're on a new island, and there's a funny structure behind the Innovation Centre as well, which we're going to show you about, but at last, after long waiting, we are on a new one-to-one Isla Nublar. Yay! But it gives us a load of scope to do some stuff. So what I've done is I've ported in the map, and there's a river over there, so you can see some differences on how the map works. And when we come over here, you can see some major differences. The hotel's in, but the landscape is a bit naff over that side. So we're going to show you what we're going to do with that. It's quite easy to get rid of, but it shows. And then we've got the hills over here. So whose is this map? Where can you get it? Well, you can't get it. I've got exclusive rights to this map at the moment, which is really cool. And anyway, you probably know, some people might know the person, but let's go and have a look at his Planet Minecraft page. He has done a fantastic map, and we're going to do some stuff on this map today, and we're going to show you around, show you all the locations that he's put in. Remember, we've got a 1993 Isla Nublar. This is Isla Nublar 2015, so this will be the island that we forever and a day will build our Jurassic World, and maybe some more on here. But so without further ado, let's go and have a look at his Planet Minecraft page. So you will know it's Revenue who has done this new map for me. Revenue has already done a load of stuff for me, and we've seen some of his fantastic work, other known as Austin. He's got a new island now. Look at this new realistic island terrain, Saganoo, which is on his map, which I just want to show you because it looks really cool. I haven't had a chance to go and have a look at it, but this has appeared since I was last on here. So look at this cool volcano he's got on it as well. So he's doing a load of good stuff there. But also, he is the maker of the Jurassic World one-to-one scale map. He has done this for me to use, which is really cool. And also, we've previously shown his world and some of his stuff, and he's done some fantastic stuff. You can actually download his older map here. He's also done an updated Innovation Centre, and he was the guy that did my wonderful ferry that's now used on my map. So it's really, really cool. So head over there. He's brilliant at boats and yachts and stuff as well. So a big thank you to Austin allowing me to use his super duper map, which is really cool. So go and head over. It is in the description, is linked to his Planet Minecraft page, and he has done a super cool island, but you haven't seen it yet. So let's head back to Isla Nublar and show off the island and show you what we're now going to do. So we come back here, and I just wanted to show you before we go off round the island. I've started excavating out the back here. Now, interestingly enough, it doesn't look too much at the moment, but it will do when we get there in the end, because we've got to eat into the forest. Because if you remember rightly, there's two massive hotels over here, or three hotels over this side. So we're going to do it gradually, but for now we're quite happy. I can actually go further back here, and it's lower down, but for now I've just done some general excavation until I start putting in the new hotels. What I'm going to do is I'm going to sort of do the beach work around here as well, and you can see the river, which is at the back, which really is quite good, because I can actually bring the river out through here. It really matches up really well. It's not exactly as a map, but nothing is. If you remember, the movie was nothing like the map in some respects. And then there's this road here, which comes down here across, and we need a bridge across the river over here. And then this goes to the hotels at the back. So it's just about placing it in, and then we can start building around. But now I have got the space to do the whole lake area. I'm not going to build it all in one go, because that'll take me quite a few episodes. So we're going to keep swapping from different worlds to different bits to keep the interest going, and we keep coming back, because this is a long-term project, as you know. It's going to be 2 to 3 years already. So we'll come over here, but now I can really start putting the monorail in. I can actually now, for the first time, put the monorail in how I want to do it across the lake. And then round the back of the Innovation Centre. What I've got to do though, something quite interesting, is I've got to really change this, because the Innovation Centre has three sides on it. Now, if you remember rightly in the movie, what is that? Oh, it's putting in some odd blocks. It does that every time I change the map, but don't worry about it. I like that little curtains look. If you remember rightly, the Innovation Centre has the labs at the back, but interestingly enough, if you have the labs at the back of the Innovation Centre like we've got here, which means they stick out. Now, I'll just show you what I mean. I've taken some of the green off, so the labs are at the back. So, and then I've got my inside here, of course, I've got my control room, which will be moved up to the top. We're going to end up moving that. I think that's just, is it the control room? I can't remember where the control room comes. Aha, there's the back of the control room there with the screens. Yeah, so that control room needs to be cut and paste out. So what I'm going to do is going to be very clever, because on the map you don't see the lab at the back at this sort of height. So what we're going to do is something we never saw in the film, which is I'm going to come to the back of here, and then I'm going to do steps down. So what I'm going to do is going to drop this lab straight down to this level and then do some steps down, which means I can have the back of the Innovation Center as it is in the movie and do that. So that's the sort of thing that we built, and we just drop it down. Now, I haven't shown you the back here. We're off going to go around the island, but look at this. The landscape is absolutely, truly fantastic. Here is where the helipad is going to go. I've got to build a helipad because there is one from Austin, of course, but the helipad is right out here. And what I plan to do is really build it up and sink the helipad in. It was above the tree line, but it was below the mountain line over there, so that's pretty good. But what it means now is we can have the monorail literally coming out the back here. Remember, there's a monorail station, and start having the monorail coming out and across here and round, as it did. I'm not so sure about this bit of a mountain that's just over here. Quite interestingly, if you just come over here, you'll be able to see it's sort of just it's just a little mountain over here, and I really need to take it out. And that's what's going to happen. See this, how it is? It is something that I will easily be able to do. The mountains there sort of stopped, and then the we've got the water park, which has got to go in here as well, so I intend to do that. But that's the way. We've now got the space to do it, which looks pretty good. So where should we go first? Well, the first place is, let's go to where everybody flies into Isla Nublar to see the difference between the 1993 map and this 2016 one. So here we are at the Needle, the famous Needle, and Austin has put it down south as well, literally in the same place, actually, very close to where the 1993 map is from everything Jurassic. And the Needle is slightly different. He has got a slightly wider area. He's got different trees as well. But I do like this, because when you fly in, and we'll fly at the valley as it does. Now, I've got it back down to 24. Otherwise, there'll be no frame rates on this. But the island where the helicopter flies in is pretty good. And when we get up here, he's put the helicopter pad landing area at the end of the valley. And it's quite easy to get to. So we've got sort of a new modern helicopter pad landing, which we'll get to very shortly. But you can see the landscape of this island is very much... it's very much jungle. It's got different jungle trees. I do like the new type of trees, and the valleys here, so we can sort of come up here and then we'll be coming straight. In fact, it's not very far up, I know. Comes up the valley, fly at the valley, and we'll come into where the waterfall is, which is just round here. It's not very far. There it is. You can see the map, and it sort of flies round, and then we go into this mountainside here with the water. Now, it needs a bit of work to it, because the map's been set up, but you can see where that big mountain comes in. There's a lake here, but it needs a bit of digging out. You need to sort of really get into this and take some of the trees out as such, like that. Some of the trees don't break though. That's what I have. See, this one won't break. The only ones that break are the jungle trees. and then you have to sort of hopefully it takes out a lot of the other trees and then leaves some back. So you have to break a lot out. That is the only problem with this map, but it's quite all right. It doesn't take too long to do that, so it's all good fun. And these just come down here like that. So it's not as comprehensive, of course, as that 1993 map, but it still looks the biz with the waterfall coming up here. So that's the waterfall area. You can see on the map, everybody watching this, if you, you're actually not going to get this map for now, but you can see where the coordinates are if it's been released later on, which it isn't at the moment. I am got privileged use of this map, so I have to respect that, of course, because I'm very lucky to be able to use it. So there's the waterfall. Right, where are we going to go next? Let's go to... let's go to the ferry part, which has been modified. We've got a lot of work to do with the ferry area for 2015. Here is the ferry landing. It does require quite a bit of work to make it work in terms of the size and shape. But what I intend to do is I'm going to bring in the ferry landing that I've got into this area and then build the trees up. But this particular landscape here does look the exact sort of very similar to the ferry landing we have, so it's a case of going to be copy and paste in. It's going to be a bit of work, but that's why I'm showing you first of all where the ferry landing is. Right, okay, so let's go and see some stuff that you'll recognize immediately from the movie. So here we are at Owen's Lake, and there's no cabin there yet, but we can build our own cabin. It's very situated close to the river, which is really cool as well, because it was sort of away from the main visitor area. We never had a Owen's Lake before on the island, and it's really cool. It looks like that. It's a quite a low, shallow lake. It was as per the movie. And if we go down here where the cabin is going to be, we have to take a few trees out. But it definitely looks like the lake. I am really impressed with this one. Really like it. If we can put his cabin here and you look across the lake, it literally looks like that. It's really well done. Really like it a lot. So, and the lake actually, rather than just being a pond, it's now a lake with a river that goes out into the main river system over here. So I really like that. Really like the fact it actually looks the part, as I say. So this literally comes out into the river system over here, and I think if I'm correct, it sort of goes left and right here. Yeah, because that goes off to the sea, and that, ooh, I thought I saw something like that, goes off back to the innovation center area and the lake area. Right, let's go somewhere else then now. So here we are at the East Dock. We've talked about the East Dock, but on the 1993, but not on the 2015. Some of the landscapes correct, but just needs, like, I don't think the beach will be this long, but it could be. We'll see when we actually build the dock. But in the 1993 map, of course, this is Nedry's demise because he was looking for the East Dock. But the hillside is still here at the back, and there are the basic roads for this 2015 map are here as per the new map rather than the old map. Some of the old roads have now gone into insignificance, and even the landscape here, the hills are here. In fact, I didn't actually have a look to see. There was none of the old roads here anymore. But so there is the East Dock. Now we'll go to something that you know from the movie. So I'm sort of interchanging between things that weren't in the movie but are on the island and things that are on the movie. So let's go to one of my favourite parts of the island, and you'll see why once we get there. So here is the famous rafter paddock area, slightly changed from our previous, and you might ask, what are these funny crosses in the middle where you see them? Well, we had the original map, and then when we had the first look at it, Austin decided to change it because it didn't look quite right, but this is sort of ready to bring the rafter paddock in, which again will be quite easy. This is a rocky part of the island, so I'm going to change the beach area to rocks and start planting some trees, and literally it's going to be quite quick. I won't be showing this on video because I'll be just porting it in, then we'll show you the sort of finished article. The road in the back here comes in the back, What I need to do is sort of change the area slightly bit where I put the raptor paddock into the forest over here, because what we didn't do with the raptor paddock before is put the run into the forest, like the where the raptors were able to run around like a enclosed forest area at the back. But I do like this. It's a brilliant sort of size. Needs a bit of work doing to it like the rest of them, but it is the right size for the rats paddock. I just need to do a bit of work on it. Won't take long. It's ready to be ported in. So where do we go now? Let's go and have a look. I'll tell you where we're going to have a look at. We'll have a look at some of the others. Gallimimus Valley. Should we go to the Gallimimus Valley? Because that was not in one of the previous maps, but it is in this one. So here we are, Gallimimus Valley. These landscapes are so big on a one-to-one map, and you can see the high mountains either side with the valley down the center and the road going through it. Where the road would come in to then drive around the particular area and drive on the Gallimimus Safari. But these mountains either side are truly fantastic. I really like them. A lot of care and attention taken to them. And the valley is pretty well self-contained as such. There's both sides of it. I've got the high cliffs that we saw. Which is really cool. Now, hopefully we've got this as Gallimimus Valley rather than the... I must remember now, I did label them. I'm sure this is the Gallimimus Valley. Rather than the... I can't remember whether it just sort of comes to the head of the valley down here. I seem to remember going around it before, or whether it goes out the other side. You can actually get out there, look, but it's a forest either end. So I really like that. Really like to put that in. So that's the Gallimimus Valley. Right, where else? We've still got loads and loads and loads of things to do. Where the Avery's going to go, I think. That might be next, Avery. So this is the road into the Avery area, the 2015 Avery, not obviously the previous one. And we've got the river, which comes out from the Avery underneath, and we've sort of got lots of mountains nearby. So this is slightly changed from the original Austin's map. He's reconfigured the area as such, and it means that we can actually put the dome in quite happily into the mountain with the mountain behind. And funnily enough, if you actually look over here, if we have the Avery over here, you've almost got the place where Owen and Claire came out to look across towards the Avery over here, which is pretty damn cool, I say that much. Let's just build it over here. So if the Avery is over there, they come across and look across the valley. It's quite interesting, but or it could have been over here somewhere. But you can still see when we get the Avery in, it's going to be pretty impressive, to say the least. I'm going to build a new Avery now, not my old one of my old map, because that's available for people to download. But we're going to have a new Avery. You can see these roads everywhere. The roads are all over the island. Some of the other things we haven't shown yet is... Oh, we haven't shown the volcano. We've got Northern Beach. We've got Northern River. We've got massive plains. We've got Botanical Gardens area as well. What else have we got? We've got the Windy River. Oh yeah, the Windy River. In fact, that's down that way somewhere. That's sort of down there, which is like a windy river through it. And we've got the Northeast Paddock, Northeast Dock, the Far North Paddock, Gyrosphere Valley. Let's go to Gyrosphere Valley. That's where we're going to go next. So now you can see the Gyrosphere Valley is a much bigger valley. It wasn't as sheer as the Gallimimus Valley. This is the Gyrosphere Valley. What I've got to work out is where we're actually going to place the gyrosphere in terms of this particular map. But you can see, remember, the valley was absolutely massive. I wonder where north is. Where's north? Because once you come out of the valley, is that north? That's towards east, south, west, north. Yeah, okay, so it'd be that way. Once we get out of the valley that way, we actually come round to where the old visitor centre is. This is going towards, it's going towards the far end of the valley, away from that area. But I think, if I'm correct, I think it sort of finishes this end and comes round in a bowl, which is pretty good. Yeah, so we've got a bowl this end, And if you remember rightly, the monorail came in the valley, came trailing down the valley as such. And I'll just come over here and see how high this is, because I am on 24 chunks, so you can actually envisage how big this is. Yes, and the monorail comes in, runs down the valley, and you can then see where we're sort of going to put it here. I think it's sort of that where the monorail finishes, doesn't it? The monorail comes along the valley and then stops, and then it's there. But the valley is absolutely massive, and it's like rolling plains. You can imagine the roller, the balls going along here. Funny enough, I wanted to actually put the gyrosphere on the far, on the opposite side, because it looked better. If you remember from the track, in fact the road is coming from this side, I have to look at that, but remember rightly, the monorail came in quite a high cliff and then stopped. Maybe it should come in from this side. I'll have to look. Ah no, this is going out, it's going out the opposite side. I have to look at the map where the monorails are and see how it looks, but you can see how big this valley is. It's absolutely ginormous. So actually, that draws me on to the fact, now we're close by, we can go and show you where the old visitor center is hidden, because they literally came out and then got into the forbidden zone, which is should be north. That's not north, is it? Oh, it is. That's north. So we are right. Then we come out this end. This will be where the innovation center is, the old center is. So I'm going to head down there and then just come back. But before we get there, of course, I forgot where I-Rex attacked the boys. And if you haven't seen this before, the river carries on out, so you can see how close. So that's the obviously that was just a valley where we've been, so it's pretty close to it. Here is the where the I-Rex comes out of the trees. And then the boys jump into the pool. But I want to do a bit more with this. Remember, if the boys jumped off here as such, and they wouldn't be able to jump down here because there's ground, so it needs the water opening out to sort of finish that off. But they came out there, the I-Rex. So I've shown that before to you guys, but it's been finished off now, so it looks pretty cool, to say the least. So that's one of my favourite areas on this map. But the map, as you can see, is absolutely just ginormous. It's absolutely massive. And then when the boys came out the waterfall, they started traveling across land and eventually came to the old visitor center, which is across the way. So we will now make my way to the old visitor center area, which we are. There it is. There's the road. The old track is here, hidden. So it's all really is concurrent with the movie, in that this track is obviously well overgrown now, but what I'm going to do is make it less overgrown as such, because I don't like it too overgrown. So I'm going to take out some, I'm going to take out some of these trees as we get there, so we come along. So it would be this overgrown, but it's not as overgrown as well. So we come round those red dots. Let's go to where the entrance is. There's no water here now, but if I just come round and follow the road round, it's got to be this big, because you remember how big that visitor centre is, and it should just stop here. I think the road just stops here. There we go. And that's where, so I've got to take all this out. Oh, they go as well. That's the first time I've seen that. That's good. It's those other ones. So these ones don't go. I know that you have to actually break them. So what I'll use is World Edit to bring that in. And what I'm going to do this time is make it completely overgrown, because last time I didn't get that quite right. So that's where the visitor center is going to be buried in the bushes. So we're going to do old and new versions. What I'm going to do is I'm going to redo the 1993 one first of all, because in terms of main road, it's hidden off the beaten track, and that's where the boys then drive back to the main area with their jeep. They drive out of here through the forest and join that road there. In fact, that's where the buggy was found, just on this road, remember, and they then came across the visitor center, which was just buried in here. So this is really realistic to the map, the new map 2015. So where else? The volcano. We didn't get to the volcano, did we? So we're going to have a look at that. So here is the volcano, and we are high up here. In fact, if I just drop down here and put F3 back on, where are we at? 878 in the volcano is 78, but it's not, because it's just like it's the deep area of the volcano. Let's go south, east, south. Let's go south. It is massive, absolutely massive. So it could be some sort of research center, thermo. Could have thermo plant on it. It gives us a lot of things to do here, like the 1993 one, and we keep coming out and we come over the edge of the volcano as such, and then it should start going down the side into the valley below. So it's very cleverly done. It's a dormant volcano. It's not as dramatic as, you know, the previous version one map, but it's still a volcano. It's a dormant volcano, and the fact is the height map's only 256, so you can have an outer rim as such. Raptor paddock is sorry, raptor paddock, the I-Rex paddock is near here as well. So there's something else we haven't been to. There's so many things. I'm not going to be able to visit them all in this thing. There's so many things on this map. It is just awesome. Really is. Right, let's go to that now. Here is the I-Rex paddock area. It's all put in. The whole map has got roads to it and out. Quite good. One of the new things that I really like, I've called it the Windy River, but it's actually the Cretaceous Cruise. So let's just go there. I think we'll go there straight away. We're pretty all right. Yeah, Cretaceous Cruise has got this fantastic, as per the map, winding waterway. Winding, really cleverly done. And you can see it on the map to the right as well as it's laid out. What a, you know, to take your canoes down and do like a cruise, Cretaceous Cruise, absolutely fantastic. So I'm trying to think now. This is going up towards the north of the island, as you can see, and then it goes off in a straight and then joins up with another part. But I do like it. If you come down here, it does look like the cruise itself as we are. What's that there? Oh, it's things in there. So I do like it. I think it comes round to high, comes out to high mountains on this side with a big cliff, if I'm sort of correct. Yeah, there isn't a big cliff on that side. I had thought of using this particular area here for the aviary. I did actually consider that start of all, but I decided to put the aviary where it should do, down the far side. But it would make some sort of feature, maybe a sort of rope bridge or coming across like that. So there are many, and I've not even got to the other areas. There are loads of areas that off, like the basically is an area for the botanical gardens. And I think this is where this actually comes out now, down this end. Oh, we're back into the windy bit. Yeah, we've done the East Dock, small paddock out to 8,000. We have the Windy River, which I've called here. We've got Northeast Paddock as well, which talk about. And we've got different things, but I do like this. Imagine coming down here in a canoe. Really fantastic. Old Visitor Centre, we've done Raptor Paddock. There's another lake as well to the north. This river just keeps winding round, doesn't it? Absolutely superb. So that is it. I wanted to get through this pretty quick because the next episode we're back to building. There's the road to this particular bit here, and there's another road there. I'd have to look. That may go out to the East Dock that way. There's gaps. Yeah, that's sort of that way. I get lost. This island is so big. It is absolutely ginormous. So there we have it. I'm not going to show any more. I think this actually goes all the way back to the main lake area, I think. I can't remember now. So many lakes and rivers on this island. Yeah, this one goes back to the main visitor area. So what I'll say is, go and have a look. He's got the page up. You cannot download this map, though. He's not releasing it for now because it's a part of a bigger project that he's doing. Go and have a look at his downloads as such, and it's all very interesting. But this island, this now gives me the sort of, this will be the final island as such. Please don't ask, I will not be releasing it. Oh yeah, there's this little island in here in the middle as well, where it goes either side. Maybe we could make a visitor attraction out of that. Really, this could be where the Cretaceous Cruise starts. I could have it here, sort of thing. But there are mountains all over this island. I keep finding stuff to build that, which is truly fantastic. And I love the fact that you've got the forest, then you've got rock faces coming out as you go. So there you have it. Thank you very much indeed for watching. I do apologize for the length of delay in the films. You might probably know if you follow me on Twitter, I'm a bit of a football addict. I've been watching the Euro Championships, although my team sadly went out to a better team last night, Iceland. Well done, Iceland. You played and gave us boys a hell of a beating. Well done, any Icelandic watchers. But I will be continuing to watch the European Championships because I like football, love football. So, and I've had, obviously, people know I've had death in the family. Father-in-law died recently, so it's not been as many videos. But we should be resuming normally. I'm not going to tell you now where we're going next episode. I know where we're going next episode, but we're going to go and build some more, going back to building. And I'll start, I love this where there's like roads going across the water. We'll start building again for next episode and carry on with our Jurassic Park, Jurassic World series. And please, guys and girls, this is, remember, a long-term project. It's going to take some months, so a lot of episodes to come. And again, we're looking forward to the new Jurassic Craft release. Jurassic Craft is coming soon, so as soon as I get my hands on the Jurassic Craft, you'll be getting the usual full-blown reviews of all the new dinosaurs. And I think I'm also going to create a new dinosaur series, I think, which is almost like a review of all the Jurassic Craft dinos and give a bit of background to them, sort of a bit of a dino spotlight. It might be very short videos, but we're going to start doing those as well. There's never more here. Look, there's more roads. I love these roads. So thank you very much indeed, guys, girls. See you next time. Please like, please sub, please comment. I'm trying to catch up with all the comments over the last few days. And see you next time. Thanks very much. Bye-bye and good night.